Welcome to r/IDon'tWorkHere, lady, where we share stories about folks that go into other businesses and have irate customers mistake them for employees. And today's first story is, lady assaults me over some hot sauce. My son told me I should put this incident on this Reddit category, so here I go. I'm new here and I don't know all the formats, but nonetheless, here we go. I am an early bird, waking up at 3:30 a.m. to prepare a fresh meal for my husband to take to work. He works at 4:45 a.m. We have one car, so he and I go off to his work and I drop him off. I'm in need of a few things from the store, so I head off to pick them up from a local grocery store that is open at 5 a.m. It's important that I note I am wearing yoga clothes, yoga pants and a loose tunic, white and gray, because I'm going home and doing my yoga to maintain my usual routine. As I'm walking through the empty store, there are mostly stock people working hard and a lady who is also my friend up front at self-checkout. I love shopping this early because it's so quiet and peaceful, and it fits into my love of calm in the morning. I stop in the condiments area to get some ketchup. Then comes crazy hot sauce lady. HL equals hot sauce lady, and me equals me. Duh. Hot sauce lady loudly exclaimed, "Why is this hot sauce so expensive?" Me, smile and shrug and then turn back to minding my own business. Hot sauce lady, yelling now, "Hello? Why are you ignoring me?" Me, I can't ignore you because you're being very loud. Also, I don't know why it's that price. I don't work here. Everyone who works here is wearing blue and orange, so do I look like that? Hot sauce lady, "Bull, I saw you talking to the lady up front." Me, "Yes, I'm a regular here and she's my friend." Hot sauce lady, "So you work here but you're off right now? So could you tell me why it's so expensive?" Me, "I'm sorry, but as I said before, I'm a regular shopper here and do not work here. What do you think I can explain about the price that will make a difference? What can anyone do for you about the price?" Hot sauce lady, "You're a—" I'll not use the word, but it rhymes with witch. "Why won't you help me?" Me, I reply sternly, "Again, I can't help you. Now please go away." With a red and irate face, I mean she could be a cartoon with steam coming out her ears, crazy hot sauce lady slams her cart into mine, causing it to hit my stomach, tearing my shirt and scratching and bruising me. I pushed her cart off mine, and at this point I had to control my temper and walk away. I started going directly to the front to tell my friend who is stationed at self-checkout to call the police. I had left my phone in my car. As I'm on my way there, hot sauce lady is reaching into my cart and throwing my items on the floor. Thankfully, my friend had already heard the commotion and decided to go ahead and call the police. One of the guys who was stocking the shelves came over and got between hot sauce lady and I. She proceeded to scream like a toddler throwing a tantrum and started provoking the stock guy by getting in his face, screaming profanities and racist comments, poking him in the chest. This guy is at least 6'2 and 270 pounds, two times her size. This went on for what seemed like forever, about 15 to 20 minutes, until the police arrived, catching her red-handed assaulting the poor stock guy, who was super patient and calm despite her abuse. The police go over and immediately put her in handcuffs. Surprisingly, while she was cuffed, she calmed down, but lied and told them that I assaulted her. They looked at her with disbelief. I'm sure it's because of what they just witnessed. The police asked me to wait while they detain her. I did. After reviewing the security footage and speaking with witnesses, she was arrested and charged with two counts of assault, vandalism, and larceny. As the security footage caught her putting things in her bag without paying. And the kicker? The hot sauce was $1.75. Yes, you read that correctly. She freaked out over $1.75. Wow. The police told me that they believed she was under the influence of some type of drug, although that wasn't verified as far as I know. Anyway, I've never had anything like this happen until it did. Hopefully nothing like this will ever happen again. The thing is, why did she complain about the price of the hot sauce if she was just stealing things anyway? That's a question that I'd like to have answered. The second story is, you have to take my order. You're Indian, I'm not. Little bit of backstory, I'm half black, Afrikaans, and half white British. Because of this mix, I'm a lighter skinned biracial. I also have long straight black hair. Mix it all together and I don't look very African or very British. I look like I'm from Southern Asia and get called Indian or Pakistani a lot. It's fine, I just correct them and most of the time it's nothing. But not this time. Okie pokie, on to the story. Cast, me, mostly European. EA, entitled A. E, employee, nice dude. So I was hungry and decided I wanted Indian. There's a local Indian takeout place near me and I wanted to take a walk, so I went there instead of having it delivered like I would usually. It's a small shop but it was quite busy, so I waited and after 10 minutes I felt a tap on my shoulder. Entitled A, "Hey, what is chicken sog paneer?" Me, "Oh, I think it's like a spinach and chicken dish and a sweet sauce. Think paneer is a sort of, cheese, like halloumi?" I was kinda guessing, I've had it once, ages ago. Me, "You should probably ask, I'm not 100% sure." Entitled A, Well, you should know. Typical teens. I just ignored her and the fact that she cut the line to ask me. The queue was still pretty long. They're understaffed, so the few there are working really hard. Entitled A. You really should help them. I can't believe you're just standing around. You're a pretty useless employee. Me. Not really listening, so I didn't catch what she said. What? Entitled A. I said you should be working. I want my order taken. They could at least hire someone who understands English for F's sake. Me. Sorry, I don't work here. I'm tired at this point, so I chose to neglect the doesn't speak English comment. Also, I spoke perfect English before, so it made even less sense. Entitled A. Of course you work here, look at you. God, you're lazy, you should be fired. Take my order. She started ranting and then started listing her order, all whilst I repeated that I don't work there. Other customers were staring, but my town sucks. No one was going to help me. Me. I don't work here. Entitled A. Of course you do, you're Indian. This is an Indian. I'm not stupid. Me. Please, I'm not Indian. I don't work here. I can't serve you. Entitled A. Don't lie to me. You are Indian. You just don't want to do your job. I'm going to speak to your manager. Hopefully he won't be an effing Indian. This really confused me. She implied that only Indians worked here, then asks for a non-Indian staff member. At this point she was causing a commotion, so an actual employee came over. Note, this person is not Indian, nor are any of the staff that I can see. Employee. Is there a problem? Entitled A. Yeah, this useless employee won't do her job. Employee. Sorry, but this person doesn't work for us. She's a customer like yourself. Entitled A. Don't BS me. She's Indian. She works here. Me. I'm not Indian. I'm British. Employee. Okay, I'm gonna have to ask you to leave. You're being racist. One, you don't have to be Indian to work here. Two, the lady said she isn't Indian and that she doesn't work here. Entitled A. I want my food. You can't kick me out. Employee. If you don't leave, I'll call the police for harassment. Entitled A proceeds to rush out of the door at the mention of police, but not without shouting swears and calling me an effing in. The employee says that he will try and have her banned from the shop. He also gave me free papadums. So overall, wasn't the worst day. The third story is, nice guy solved the problem with entitled Karen in his own way. Firstly, English is not my first language. I'm Danish, so I apologize for errors and my attempt with Google Translate. This story is a bit different than others in here, and at the same time it is not. I also thought that this person, nice guy, was working in the store where this story takes place. NG, nice guy. EK, entitled Karen. Me. So I was in a very typical Danish supermarket. I had decided that I should have cold skull and kammer junker for dinner. I don't think this doesn't make any sense for most people, so let me describe. Cold skull is like buttermilk with vanilla and lemon. Kammer junker can be translated straight to champer page, which I don't think help any further, but it's kind of a biscuit that goes perfect to the buttermilk. So, I entered the store and couldn't find those champer biscuits. I'm looking for an employee and saw a young man wearing a white shirt and red tie. The store has red and white in their logo, so I found it logical that this was his uniform. Me. Excuse me, but can you tell me where I can find the champer biscuits? Nice guy. Oh, I'm sorry, but I don't work here, so I can't tell. Me. My apologies. I thought you were working here. We smiled at each other and we both continued our grocery shopping. I kept searching for the biscuits or an employee. Woohoo! In the end, I found the champer biscuits. There were only 5 or 6 bags left. As I said, this is a very popular dessert in Denmark in the summer, so it's very typical that the shops run out. I walk around the shop a little to see if there was anything else I needed. Then nice guy came over to me. Nice guy. Hi, I found the champer biscuits and took a bag for you as there are only a few bags left. Me. Thank you so much, but I finally found them. But anyway, thank you for helping. It was very nice of you. Nice guy. No problem. You can't get buttermilk without champer biscuits. He put the bag in place and I went up to the checkout. I put myself in line. The queue was quite long and the girl sitting at the cash desk had some problems with the product, and you could tell she was getting more nervous. Clearly because the queue was getting longer and she couldn't solve her problem. This means that people can get impatient, especially our beloved entitled Karen type. Suddenly, I heard a loud shrieking voice that made everyone in the nearest radius look at her. Entitled Karen. Hey, can you open one more cash desk? As I said, she got pretty much everyone looking at her. Now she had eye contact with nice guy, who had been looking at some different items by himself. Nice guy. I'm sorry, but I don't work here. Entitled Karen. That's not true. I saw you help him finding those champer biscuits. She points at me. I was about 2 meters or 6.5 feet behind her. Nice guy. Yes, that was because he couldn't find them, and I chose to help him. Entitled Karen. Fine, but then can you also help me by opening one more cash desk? Have you seen how many people there are in line? Now you go open a cash desk and stop with whatever you're doing. It must be said that Nice Guy had a basket filled with 7 to 10 items, and Entitled Karen had her cart with different goods. Nice Guy walked quietly towards her. Nice Guy. Try listening for a second. I don't work here. Yes, I have seen how long the queue is. No, I don't open one more cash desk. and yes, I will for sure stop whatever I am doing. After which, he took his basket and poured all his goods into her cart. We were several in the queue who started laughing very loudly, and entitled Karen was completely red in her head. You could see the mixture of anger and embarrassment when it suddenly came to her head that Nice Guy probably wasn't working in the store. Nice Guy went out of the store without buying his goods. I feel sorry for Nice Guy, but I wish I could thank him for the laugh he gave me and the others in the store. Thanks for listening. Have a great day.